You can use free apps to make t-shirt designs that earn thousands of dollars on print-on-demand websites like Redbubble and Merch by Amazon. I'll get straight to the point and tell you about one of the best all-rounders which works on both iPhone and Android, Adobe Spark. The reason I think it's one of the best all-rounders is because it's free, easy to use, and has text effects like these that make your design look great with a few taps. I'll show you how to get the most out of it in this video. Here's an example for you. This t-shirt is making over $4,000 profit per month on Merch by Amazon right now. I'll recreate it using Spark in no time at all. First, I'm updating the text, then selecting secondary style to change the color of specific words to green, now finding a similar font, finally changing the alignment to left and the size. That's how easy it is to make designs that sell. I'll give you a guided tour of the app now so you can get the most out of it because there's some really impressive free features. The default page when you open the app is featured templates. You can scroll down and select one to edit, or remix as they call it, and you can change anything with a tap. On the templates page, you can scroll across the different categories at the top to see if there's something you like the look of. Just avoid the ones with the yellow premium icon in the top right because they're paid only. Some of the free templates are useful, or you can press at the top to search for more specific options. You might type Christmas to get festive designs like these. To create a blank canvas, press the big green plus button at the bottom, and then solid colour. You have to choose a colour now, but that will be ignored later when saving. I recommend using a colour that your t-shirt or other product will actually be, because Spark offers useful design suggestions based on what you choose. If you're not sure, go with black, because people tend to buy darker colours more frequently. Press Next and then Custom so you can set the size of your canvas. 4500 by 5400 is more than enough for most print-on-demand t-shirts. Then press Done. This watermark at the bottom doesn't get saved with the final image, so you can just ignore it, or if it annoys you, just tap it and remove it manually right away. You can zoom in and out by pinching the screen as you'd expect, and as it says, just double tap to edit the text. I love this text editor because it shows you the text on a separate screen, rather than awkwardly having to mess around on the actual design, then accidentally clicking and moving other elements around like many other apps force you to do. You can single tap to select the text and access the options. In the edit section, you've got basic options like delete, duplicate, but also the secondary style which I used earlier with the green colour to have different styles within the same text box. You'll find a decent selection of fonts to choose from, so just have a see what works well with the text you've chosen for your design. You can also add extra fonts by scrolling to the end and pressing the plus. This is a font that I added earlier. You can see the full library of additional fonts and scroll down, or press the filter button at the top, which allows you to specify criteria like a decorative, thick font. When you find one that you like, just tap it and it'll be downloaded and added for use. The colour section shows you suggestions based on the background colour that you chose earlier, or you can set your own custom colours. The colour on the left is for the text, as you can see it's updating when I move it around, and the right box is for the shapes that you choose, if any. The shape section is where you can remove the text background that's there by default by just cancelling it off, or you can add different shapes if you want them as part of your design. There's loads to choose from, as you can see. The banner and the decorative ones are the most useful in my opinion, but again it depends on what style you're going for and what you're selling. The effects section helps your design pop because you can add flair like a shadow or an outline, also known as a stroke in Photoshop. Just click to apply the effect and then click the settings icon to adjust it. The Align tab isn't just for left, center, and right. You can use the magic setting to get your chosen text to line up so it's more aesthetically pleasing, or apply curved text. At first it'll go full circular, then tap again to have curved. In spacing, you can change the letter and line distance to your desired preference and adjust the shape if you've got one. Finally, the style section's got this circle that reminds me of a classic iPod. You can drag it around forever to get constant style changes until you see one that you like the look of. So if you're not sure what you want to go for, this is a good option to try out first to get some ideas generated. Back to the main menu, you can add an image, icon, sticker, or logo from your own files or those in the Spark library. The icons are kind of like clip art, so you might not want to use those. If you want to add your own image, just click Add Image. When you're done, click the icon at the top right and you'll be prompted to choose a transparent background for your design. If you're using an iPhone like me, the transparency can get ruined if you save it to camera roll using the Save Image feature. To avoid that, you can save it to Files instead by scrolling to the end and clicking More, then scrolling down and pressing Save to Files. You can then upload the design to your favourite print-on-demand website from your phone. Here I am uploading the design from my phone to Redbubble, ready to sell. You don't need to do anything too fancy to be making sales. As I said earlier, this one's making over $4,000 profit per month on Amazon. Here's another example, $2,800 profit per month right now, and another $3,400 profit for this one. You can make these quite easily in Spark. I'm not saying you'll be making that sort of money immediately, but clearly it's possible using these simple designs. Hopefully you found that helpful. If you're interested in making money from text-based designs, check out my video called How to Make Text-Based Designs That Sell, and subscribe for more content released weekly. Thanks for listening right till the end. If you scroll down, your reward is a giveaway in the comments section.